of the second-order equation, we can write that as n times n plus 1. They are divided out by y, so y doesn't appear anymore. Okay, so given this situation, this is the equation we are having for zero potential. I mean, I have not sketched the full thing, but it has this been sort of covered in other courses? Can I assume that this is generally known? Okay, good. So we want to deal with this equation. It's a very nice equation. Let's understand a little bit about it. Primes are not differentiation in R. The primes are differentiation in R. Okay. Now, for large R, what is the solution? Let us consider. Okay. For large R, can ignore angular momentum term. Okay. We will suppose, at least some crude approximation, we will throw this term away. We will bring it back later on. Okay. We will consider the case where for large R, because of this 1 by R squared term, we will suppose we can throw this away. Now, by this, I mean h bar squared I squared by times R. This is our eigenvalue equation. So let us have a quick look at it. What is it saying? For large R, we get minus h bar squared by 2m, 1 by r, r prime, is equal to h bar squared k squared by 2m times r. Yeah. So, looking at this equation, you will feel like making a particular substitution. What is that substitution? You want to solve this equation. No, in order to reach there, see there is all sorts of stuff happening. It's some new function. So let u equal to r times r. You see why that's helpful? But this becomes u double prime. This r goes there, it becomes u. So the equation then simply becomes minus u double prime is equal to k squared. Very simple. Upon making that substitution. And therefore, u is equal to e to the power of ikr plus e to the minus ikr, a and b. This is the solution. For large r, this is the solution.